Hi, now we are going to learn about how to create and use user-defined variable in Automation Year 2019. Here is our agenda, the variables overview, then all types of user-defined variables with demo, like how to create and use all the type of user-defined variables with multiple live examples, then loop function and variables. So let's begin. The variables overview. Variables are used to hold one or more values. Basically, it's a storage location. And instead of repeating these values in a multiple places in your code, the variables are stored in the computer memory once and used wherever it's required in your code. Let me give you the example for that. Let's assume I am developing one of the bots. For that, I need this information. I need this Excel, the highlighted field value, like range D2. I need the value for my bot execution or else development. I need this information. Like multiple times I need the same values. So first time what will happen is I'll using the open spreadsheet command, then use the get single value, I'll extract this information. For the next time also I don't want to repeat the same actions. Whenever first time I'm opening the Excel spreadsheet, right? At this first time I'll assign this value to one of the variable. So for the next time I don't want to open the spreadsheet and get this value. Directly I can pull the variable. Since the variable can be stored in the computer memory, directly I can pull the variable. Instead of opening the spreadsheet and doing the actions, you can use the variable. That's what we are using, the variables. The Enterprise Year 2019 offers a variety of variables, each designed to hold specific type of data and it's intended for specific use. And the different type of variables in Year 2019, the system variables, user defined variables, credential variables, global values and the work item variables. Now we will discuss about system variables and the user defined variables. The system variables. System variables are predefined variables that returns specific values about the machine on which the bot is executed. And the users cannot edit the values of a system variable. Since these are all predefined variables, so the users cannot make any changes to the system variables. And here we have a list of system variables such as clipboard, date and time, date, hour, machine, millisecond, minute, month, second, as well as AA control room, installation path, task name, CPU usage, machine, RAM usage, OS name and the other informations. And the right side we have a description for each and everything, like the date returns the date including hours, minutes and seconds. Like the hour returns the hours in hour format. Like this, the system variable is working. You don't need to make any other changes. Directly, you can use the system variables. Already I have explained about the system variable. The user-defined variables. Users and some actions create user-defined variables to temporarily hold values. The user, which is nothing but the bot developer. The bot developers or some actions create user-defined variables to temporarily hold the values. In the year 2019, we are having 13 different type of variables, 1-3. We have 13 different type of variables in the year 2019. In the previous version, version 11.3 only has 4 type of variables. Value type, list type, array type and the random type. So there are only 4 types, but in this year 2019, it has 13 different types. So let's see. The first one is any variable. It can store all data types, which is it can be string, number, date, time, boolean, credential, any kind of data type, you can store this to any variable. If you are not sure about the data type, so whenever you are automating the data, but you are not sure about the data type, then you can choose the any. But it's not a recommended method, but you can choose it. String variable. So in the string variable, you can store like number variable or else character, or anything into empty values. Something into the string variables. One of the most widely used data type is a string. Maximum we are using the string variable. Even it can be the text or else characters or else empty values. You can store anything to the string variable. That's the reasons maximum we are choosing the string variables. Then number. It can store the numeric values. So only numeric value supported by the number variable. Date time. It stores a value containing a single date and time value. Then boolean, it stores either a true or false value. So there are only two options, either you can choose true or false by this boolean. Credential, it helps to store a password. file. It only stores a file path. So particular file path, you can save this to variable. For that, you know, each and every time you should not mention the file path. Directly you can pull the variable instead of mentioning the file path. Window. It can stores a window title and window URL. Then list. It stores a sequence of boolean, number or string values. Then dictionary variable. It stores data in the form of key value pairs. You know, the dictionary, we need to lot of discussion about that. We'll discuss. Then record. It stores a single row of values extracted from a table. And the table variable. It stores multiple values in a table of rows and columns. And the table and record, these are all interlinked. Since if the table is an entire table, let me give you the example. The table which is including every details, all the data, which means called as table. But the record, which is nothing but the active record. Currently, it's activated on the third row, right? Currently, it's available in the fifth row. So wherever the record is activated, which is called as record in the loop function. So first time it will consider as 1, 2, 3, like this. So first time, you know, whenever we are in the first line, first row, the record will be considered as active row. The active row is considered as the record. I'll give you the example. In the demo, I will give you the clear example for that. And the form variable. It stores the form data. The variable recommendation. Before using the variables, you should follow these kind of guidelines. The variables cannot be named as Java or other programming keywords, such as string, boolean, integer, public, class, private, float, break, double, native, and finally. You know, also we have other keywords such as date, day, hour, minute, millisecond, like this. You should not use any kind of programming keywords. You should try to avoid the other keywords. Just try to give the unique words. And once you created the variable, you cannot make any changes to the variable. Like in the name or type field, you cannot make changes. So please ensure to give the proper name and choose the proper type before make the changes. So once you have created everything, then you can delete and recreate one more. You cannot make the changes. The variable name must not start with the number value. Blank values are not allowed within the variable, blank or space values. The variable name should not be too very length. Try your best to make sure that the name you assign your variable is accurately descriptive and understandable to another reader. So another reader also should understand your variable. It should be easy to understand. Press F2 to display the variables. So these are all the guidelines which we have. Let me go to the control room and I will create the variables. Let me click on create a bot. I will call the name as user defined one. Click on create and edit. Perfect. Now we are in the task edit bot window, task editor. So just click on the variables. Here you can see user defined. The prompt assignment, which is a predefined variable. It doesn't have any values. So you can use this prompt assignment in any of your tasks. In order to create the variable, just click on this icon, create variable. Just click on this icon. And we have on the top create variable, cancel or create. The name, we are providing the names. You can provide any names as per the guidelines. So as we discussed earlier, you should not give the programming keywords. Like as my recommendation is, just use V before every variables. Just use V or where, something like that, where string. So it's not a common keywords, it's a unique keyword. Like this, you can provide your name. You can assign the name and the description field. This is an optional field. This is for your reference. We are updating the description only for the reference. If you want to fill the details, you can use it or else just leave as it is. And constant read only, uses input and uses output. Okay, let me quickly, theoretically I will explain that, and in the demo I will explain clearly how it's working and each and everything. Constant read only, which is nothing but you can select the constant read only option to ensure values cannot be edited or overwritten. If you want to, you know, value should not be edited or overwritten, you need to choose the constant read only. In the demo, I'll explain how we can use the constant read only option. Then use as input. The variable holds a value that can be passed from the parent part to a child part. First of all, you should know what is parent part and what is child part, which is nothing but, like, you know, let's assume one of the example for web page. So in the web page, whenever you are login, you will see the login page with the username and the password details. Whenever you are entering the details, then only you can move to the next page, which is a home page. So just assume that we are in the initial page. Initial login page will be considered as child page, child bot. And the next one, you are moving to the home page, right? That's a parent bot. So that's the reason the variable holds a value that can be passed from the parent bot to a child bot and use as output. So when you check this checkbox, the variable holds a value that can be passed from a child bot to the parent bot. So this is the difference between the user's input and user's output. While doing the demo, I'll explain how it's working, like user's input and the user's output, constant read only, everything, how it's working. I'll explain that. Next, type. In the type dropdown, you can see 13 different type of variables: any, string, number, date and time, boolean, credential, file, window, list, dictionary, record. So let me click on anything. Any. So when you click on any, the default value, you can see it has been blocked. It cannot update any values into the default value since it can be any type. And when you select string, now in the default value, you can update some values. Default value, which is nothing but if there is no other values. So whenever you are trying to assign the variables to for any of the value, if there is a value is not available, then what is the value needs to be returned, like that. Or else you can use this for any other update purpose. For anything, you can use it for a default value. Then number, when you select the number, you can see it keep changing. The default value keep changing as per the data type. It will change date and time. So when you select the date and time, the default value will reflect the date, hour, and the format, date format. So here, if you select this date, this hour is very, very mandatory. Let me select the date. Here you can see it's a default field. So next, you need to click on this one, this icon, and you need to select the date drop down. Okay. Here you need to select the time. This is mandatory. You need to use the both, or else just leave as it is. Boolean. So in the Boolean list, you can see only false or true value. It can be either true or false. Where we can use this Boolean? While comparing the data. In the string variables, we are comparing the data, right? Like first value to second value. If the data is matching, you need a true result or else false result. At the time, you can use this variable, Boolean variable. Credential variable. Here in the default value, we have two options: credential and insecure string. Insecure string is you can update any credentials into the text box. Credential, you need to pick it from the folder, locker. As of now, I have not created any lockers. In the credential, we have, in the left side, we have credentials. We need to create the credential, then only we can pick it from the locker. It's more secured. But this is not secured. You need to manually type this variable. And file. So here, you can assign the file path in the control room file. So for the control room file, first what you need to do, you need to assign the desktop file to control room. Then you can choose from the control room file. Just click on browse and directly you can choose it from control room. So if the file is available in your desktop, you need to choose the desktop option and click on browse. It will directly connect it to the your desktop. Then you need to, you can choose the particular file. That's what this option is working. It will hold the file path link. That's it. It will not hold the entire file. Just it will hold the file path. So whenever it's required, you can use the file path. Window. In the default window, you can see only the presets. But when you refresh this window, you will see all the activated window. So as of now, it's a Notepad, Google Chrome, Excel, PPT, and I have some other files. It will display all the activated windows in the drop-down list. You can pick it any of the value. Then you can assign this to the variable. It will help you to. So each and every time you do not want to mention the window or title, directly you can pass the variable. For that reasons, we are using the window variable. And it's still loading. Do not cancel it. So if you cancel it, what is happening is it's creating some other errors in uninterrupted or else some other errors. So just wait for a second. Okay. Now it's refreshed. Now in the drop down list, you can see activated all of the available activated windows, control room, PowerPoint, sample file, videos, documents, and the other details. Everything is available. So now you can select anything, and here it displayed window title as well as window application path. It can hold everything. So directly you can use it. So instead of each and every time, you don't want to select the window, refresh and select the window. Directly you can use the variables. List. In this list, you can assign multiple variables such as list 1, 1, 2, 3, then plus 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Like this, you can assign multiple values to this list variables. You can use this to the multiple times in the bot, you can use it. Also here, subtype, it can be data type as any string, number or boolean. So this list type, this value can be any types, any string, number or boolean types. Dictionary variable. So this is what we need to discuss. In the subtype, we have any string, number and boolean. Key. What is the key? So I'll explain in the Excel itself. So let's assume on the C column, this is the key and D is a value. So for the product 1, we have 1200, product 2, 1300, product 3, 1400, like this. So whenever you are using this key, product 1, the value is 1200, right? Product 3 is 1400. So if you are using the another bot or else within the bot, if you want to get the information from this spreadsheet, directly you can call the product 2. You are not sure where the value is available for the product 2, but directly you can call product 2. Product 2 is a C column, product value is a D column. So key is a key value pairs. Like for the Outlook, we are having some of the common key. So let me give you the example for that. Dot email subject, dot email from, dot email to, email CC, email BCC, email message. So these are all common dictionary keys. In the demo, I will explain how we can use the dictionary keys. For now, I'll test 1, 1, 2, 3. And I will add one more dictionary. Four, five, six. So whenever I call text 2, it will display the value as 456. I'm not sure what the value is available, but whenever I'm calling the test 2, it will display the values. Like this, you can use the dictionary variables. So it can have string or any kind of variables. Record. So what is that record? Record is mostly used for the table operations. Like in the loop, we are using the table, right? So first time it will display the first row, second time second row. So the activated row will be considered as record. And the table is considered as the entire table, the whole table considered as table. So let me go to the examples. First, let me create one of the variable. Let me create a string variable. And I'll type the name as vstring. I'm not checking any checkboxes right now. Default value, I'll update 500 now. So let me create. And in the action, I'll just type message box and I'll get the message box to display the values. Just drag and drop the message box. Press F2. So use a defined variable. So prompt assignment is default, predefined by the automation anywhere. Vstring, we just know we have created. And assigned 500 as a value. Let me click on yes, insert, apply, save and run the task. Done. The message box has been displayed as 500. So we got the exact results. Whatever the value has been assigned, it displayed that accurately. Then let me close this one and I'll open the Excel spreadsheet and I'll display this value, any values, so you can understand very easily. For that, let me go to Excel Advanced and open command. Just drag and drop open first. So desktop file, you need to browse and get the file, but the browse is taking so much of time. That's the reason I'll go to info and get the file path. Either you can browse and get the file path, or else directly you can paste the file path. That's up to you. And also sheet contains a header. Yes, my sheet contains header. So I'll check this checkbox and I'll click on apply. Next, I'll use the get single cell option. Get single cell. So at this time, I want to get the specific cell, which is range D2. Range D2 and assign this to one of the variable, right? So I'll assign this to vstring. As of now, we have created only one variable. I'll assign this to vstring variable. So let me click on apply. Click on save and run the task. Now we can see the results. Previously in the default value, we have assigned the value as 500, but currently we are giving the separate values, such as in the cell D2 we are assigning. Perfect. It displays the value as 1200. So previously the default value mentioned as 500, but it's displaying the correct value, the range D2, which has 1200. It displays the value. So the task is completed now. We have extracted and assigned the D2 value to one of the variable, the string variable. Like in the get single cell, we have assigned this to vstring variable. That's the reason we got. Next, let me create the vany. In the type, I'll select any and name as vany. I will not check any checkboxes. Let me click on create. And in this drop down list. So previously we have selected string, right? At this time I will use any, vany, and I will click on apply. In the message box also I will display vany. Let me click on save and run the task. Perfect. It display, it's getting the values from the Excel spreadsheet and it displayed. So currently we have assigned the values to vany. So this is just an example. Now I am assigning the particular cell value to the vany and string variables. Next, let me create the other variable, the number. Vnumber. At this time also, get single cell and I will assign this to, I am trying to assign this to V number, but in this drop down list I cannot see any V numbers because of it can stores only the string values. You can assign this to string variables. You cannot do any actions with the numeric values. It's not accepted. So wherever it's required, you can use the numeric values, number variable. So in the number variable, let me default value I will assign 20. I will apply. I will disable these actions, other two actions. So in this message box, how to display the number variable in the message box? It's quite difficult. So when you press F2, in this drop down list also you cannot see the V number, since it can display only the string variables, the numeric values as well as the date variables. You cannot see the date variable as well as numeric values under this message box drop down. For that we have a workaround. For that what you can do, just type dollar symbol and start typing SY. So when you start typing, on the above it will display the list of items. Now I want to display system details. So sorry for that, we need to type V number at this time. So start type V number, then dot. When it type dot, it will display another drop down list, which is number to string and the other items. So just click on number to string. Currently what we are doing is number values cannot be displayed with the message box. That's the reasons we are converting this to string values, then only you can display. Let me go to the item and I will show you. So these are all typecasting. So if it's a value is a boolean, you can convert this to dot invert dot new to number dot to string. The number value converted to dot decrement dot increment and dot to strings. Like this, you need to convert the values, then only you can display. So the message box, please understand that the message box cannot be display the numeric values. First you need to convert. For that we have a workaround, such as just press dollar sign and type your variable. So if you are using the system variable, you need to type system SY. When you start typing, you can see all the system variables in the drop down list. Then you can pick it and do the actions. At this case, I want to type just V, since my variable name is V number. So I'll start typing. On the above, I can see the list of items. Whatever the items are user defined variable, everything is displayed. So V number, after the V number, I want to press dot symbol. When you press dot symbol, again on the above, you can see one of the drop down, which has decrement, increment and dot to string. So just now we saw that, right? Yeah, the number you need to decrement, increment or to strings. Like this, you can convert and display, or else you can use anywhere. Then only it can be displayed, number to string. Just click on apply, save, run. And for the date, the calculation is different. Next I will show you how to display the date variable in the message box. Done. It displays the value now. So in the default message box drop down, it's not available. That's the reasons we have created the workaround method. We have used the new workaround method, which is just press dollar symbol and start typing your variable V number and the drop down. On the above, we have got the drop down. Just select, then press dot. Then you will get the drop down list. Here you can select this. Like this, you can use the convert the variables to string variables. Now we are done with that. Next, we'll create the another variables. Date time. V date time. I'm not selecting anything. And the default value. So let me select any of the default value. Today's date 29 and the hour. So when you select the date, the time is mandatory field. Just select any of the time. If you want to change the time zone, you can change it or else leave as it is. So where we can use this date and time variable. For that, let me go to the actions and search loop. So within the loop, we have lot of sub functions, such as for each row in a CSV or text, for each row in table, for each row in a SQL data set, dictionary, email, Excel advanced. Like this, we have lot of sub actions. So in the email, we need to provide the date and time. So for each and every actions, like this, for the multiple actions, we need to provide the date and time. So whenever you need a date, when received date is on or before. So here you need to provide the date, right? Here you can assign only the date variable. You cannot assign the other variables. So at this time, you can use it. When received on date is on or after. So after date and the before date. For this you need to create two variables. Then you can assign this to the particular items. Like this you can use the date and time variable. Let me click on reset. And the next one is Boolean. So Boolean, how we can use it? The Boolean. VBoolean. Create. Now I will disable all the other items. So it will not get confused. Okay. Then let me go to the actions. Then string operations. I want the string operations compare. Source string. Source string, I will update automation anywhere. In the compare to string also, automation anywhere. Automation anywhere, 1, 2, 3. Yeah. I will update 1, 2, 3. So the source string and the compare to string, it's not matching now. In the match case, what we need a result. Like here we can assign only the output to variable. It can be any variable or Boolean variable. Why we are here, you know, in the A29, it will display the correct variable type. So for this type, we can use only the Boolean, right? It can be either true or false values. For that, it display Boolean. But why we are getting the any variable? The any, which is nothing but it can hold any kind of data types. That's the reason for each and every variable, it will display V any. If it's required, you can use this to V any, but please ensure to use only the Boolean type of variable but for this kind of items. So if you are not sure the data type, then you can go with any. If you are sure about this, but for this time we are sure this is a Boolean type variable. For the true or false comparison, we need to use the Boolean type. So that I will go with VBoolean. Just select and click on apply. And I'll type the message box and drag and drop. Drag and drop the message box to display the values. So the VBoolean. VBoolean is also not displaying the result. So let me type $ VBoolean dot toString dot to number or toString. Anything you can do that. Let me click on apply, save and run the task. I'm not sure why they are only displaying the string type of variables. They can display any kind of variables in the message box. But in future, they will make the changes. I'm not sure about that. Done. It displays the value as false. Since for the source string, we have provided automation anywhere. And the two strings, the compare two strings, we have provided automation anywhere 1, 2, 3. We have differentiated the values. That's the reason they display the value as false. So let me go to the compare action once again and I will update, delete the 1, 2, 3. Click on apply, save and run the task once again. So we can see the true result at this time. Done. Now it's display the correct value, true, since we have deleted the 1, 2, 3 character from the two string. That's the reason to display the true value, correct. Now it's matching with both the datas. Like this, we can compare the to data and assign this to Boolean variables. That's the reason the Boolean variable is working. The next one is credential variable. So in this credential variable, as of now I have not created any credential. So if it's required, I can go with insecure string. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Like this, you can update any values to the insecure string. So whenever the password field, if you want to update any of the password field, you can use this insecure string. You can assign the values. Then the file. So let me select the file and we update the name as vfile. In the control room, I don't have any other files. So I'll go with desktop file. Let me click on browse. Done. It displayed the select file window. So I'll select one of the file. I'm selecting this file. Now you can see what is happening. Yeah, it's updating only the file path. It's not saving the entire file. Just it's updating the file path. So whenever it's required, the file path is required in the bot, you can use the variable. So instead of each and every time, what you will do is you'll just browse, and each and every time you are selecting the file, right? So in order to avoid that, it can store the file path to the variable. So we have assigned this to one of the variable, vfile variable. Next, window. Vwindow. In the default value, in the drop down, you can see all the available windows are listed. Like whatever the windows are available in my desktop, everything is displaying in the available windows list. PowerPoint, sample file, videos, documents, and everything. So whatever the windows are required, you can choose it. So each and every time, you don't want to mention the window name. So for maximum number of tasks, it will ask you to mention the window name. At the time, you should not go to the refresh and select the window. Directly you can pass the variable. Once you hold the window name, directly you can pass that. Just click on create. So where we need to use the dictionary variables. So maximum we are using the dictionary variables in the loop operations. So in the loop operations, again for each email in the mailbox, here we need to assign this to the dictionary variables only. Here you can see the assigned current value output to the dictionary variable. That's the reason we are using the dictionary variables. The dictionary variable, which is nothing but we have used the key and values. So currently, let me click the V dictionary. Key is test 1 and value is 123, right? I would like to give you one more example for that. Before that, let me, you know, complete the other variables like table and the record. V record default value is, you know, let's leave as it is. And also I'll create V table. Okay, now I have, you know, just drag and drop the Excel open command. Excel open action, desktop file I have chosen, this Excel file. Then sheet contains header, I have selected each and everything. And after that I want to use in the Excel advanced, get all the cells. Just drag and drop, get multiple cells. Here we have selected all rows and assign the value to variable. Here we can assign this value to only the table variable. Since it's a table, so we need to assign this to only the table variable. Like this we have assigned. And next we will display the values into the message box. So message box. So in this loop function, iterator, we need to select for each row in a worksheet. So here we need to assign this value, because of the loop function, how it will works like, first time it will get the information from the first row, second time second row, third time third row. So first time the record will be considered as first row, second time second row. It's like a counter function. It's like a counter variable. The record you can consider, it's a counter variable. And you need to assign this to vRecord variable. We have assigned. Just click on apply. And in the message box, now you need to display the vRecord. Index number. So the index number, which is nothing but the column numbers. The column 1, 2, the column starts with 0. So in this list, in this year 2019, it starts with, index starts with 0. So please ensure that A is column index 0, B index 1, C index 2, like this. So I want the information of one, as well as I'll add one more index. V record index at this time 2. So I'll click on insert. Perfect. It displaying the values. So currently in the message box we are displaying the V record. The first time it display the row number 2. Since already we have contains the header, that's the reason it is displaying the 2, 2, 9 product 2, 2, 10 product 3. It displaying all the values. So in the table, which is the entire table, will be considered as the table variable. The record is the active row, which is counter. It will increment each and every time. First time 1, second time 2, third time 3. Like that, the record will works. So record, do not consider as recorder. It's an active row. Just consider as active row. Okay, let's discuss about V dictionary variables. So in this list, we have assigned two keys. For the test 1, we have assigned the value as 1, 2, 3. For the test 2, we have assigned the value as 4, 5, 6. So we have assigned two key values. So let me go to the actions and message box. I will display the variables. Just drag and drop the message box. Here, just press F2. In the drop down list, select V dictionary and the dictionary key. So when you select the V dictionary, you will come to know the dictionary key. In this dictionary drop down list, you can see the dictionary variable types. So we have assigned two keys, right? Test 1 and test 2. So now this is a user defined variable. That's the reason in the drop down list it is displaying. But whenever you are automating the PDF automation or else Outlook automation, whenever you are using the other dictionary variables, it will not display the keys. This is a user defined variable. That's the reason it is displaying the key. But if you are using the, if you are automating the other Outlooks or anything, you need to use these kind of variables. Let me show you that. Like for the Outlook automation, the key value is email subject, email from, email to, email CC, email BCC. These are all the keys. So in the dictionary key, you need to update the value as dot email from, dot email to. Something like that you need to mention. Now I will go with test 2 and click on yes, insert, apply, save, run. Now I am expecting the value as 456 in the message box. Since for the test 2 key, we have assigned the value as 456. That's the reason it will display the value as 456. Let's wait for a moment and result. Done. It displays the value as 456. Since for the test 2 key, we have assigned the value as 456. That's the reason it displays the value as 456. So this is the dictionary variable. So for the dictionary variable, let me give you the one example once again. So if you are very new to the automation anywhere, you will get confused. For that, you need to practice. Practice only helps you a lot. So in dictionary variable, key, the first key is test 1 and we have updated the value as 1, 2, 3. The second key is test 2 and 4, 5, 6. We have updated the value. So in the message box, I have put only the test 2. I have not mentioned anything. Like VLOOKUP concept, most of you are aware of that VLOOKUP. Like this, it will work. So in the test 1, let me update this to Excel so you can understand very easily. For this test 2, we have updated 4, 5, 6. Like this, if we have test 3, test 4, something like that, what will happen is corresponding values. So for a particular key, what is the values available? Now it will display the values. So this is just for example. In the email automation, we have these dictionary keys. email subject, email from, email to, email CC, email BCC, something like that. We need to use the dictionary keys in the email automations. So we'll discuss, you know, while doing the email automations, we'll discuss clearly. And the next we'll see users input and users output. For that, we need to create one more user defined bot. First, you know, let me go to the V file. Okay. Just edit the V file and I'll assign this to use as output. V file, we have particular file path and I'll click on apply and I'll click on save now. I'll close everything. Go to the home page and click on create a new bot. User defined to create edit. So basically variables. So the variables you can assign or call the variables within the bot only. You cannot assign the particular variable to the other bots. But in this year 2019, we can use the same variables in the other bots, like the output variables. So whatever the variables are available in the previous bot, we can use the same variables in the another bot. So currently I have created one more bot, like user defined to. So let me call the run action. So I'll call the previous bot user defined one. For that, in the task bot, let me drag and drop the run. Here in the control room file, just click on browse. Where is that user defined one? Yeah, here is it. Click on confirm. We have other actions like do not repeat, repeat n times, repeat for, assign the output to variable. So here you need to create the dictionary variables. Then only you can output the exact variables. So let me create the dictionary variables. For that, here in the drop down list, just select dictionary and V dictionary 2, or else VDIC. I'll update VDIC. Then I'll drag and drop the message box. Just drag and drop the message box. In this message box, just press F2 and V dictionary key. So in the dictionary key, it will ask you to enter the dictionary key value. So here the key, which is nothing but in the previous task, in the previous bot, we have used the name, right? So let me cancel it and go to the previous bot and I will show you that first. Let me click on cancel. User defined one. In this user defined one, the variable list, under the variable list, we have used the. So currently I want to output this V file into the another task, another bot. So here I have checked this checkbox, uses output. So I need this link in the another task. So second, in the second bot, I want to extract the particular link. That's the reasons I am going to use here the name, the variable name, which is the key value, dictionary key. In the task 2, you need to use the particular variable name. So here the name is V file. That is the key now. So let me go to the second bot once again. User defined 2. Just press F2. The drop down list, you need to choose V dictionary and the dictionary key. Here you need to manually update. Here there is no drop down list since these are all not the user defined variable. At this time, you need to manually type the values. So I'll type V file. So the key is the name, variable name, whatever the name you have assigned to the particular variable, that is the dictionary key now. So let me assign V file and click on yes, insert, apply, save the task and run. Now you can see the results. For this task, we have created only the one variable, V dictionary, but this is, we have not assigned anything to this variable. Just we have drag and drop the run function. We have called the first bot, which is user defined one, and we have assigned all the user defined variable to this variable, dictionary variable, v dictionary variable. Next, in the message box, we are displaying the v file. Let me click on run. Done. Now you can see it displays the value as the perfect file name. What we have done? Just in the bot, from the bot 2, we have called the first bot. Then in the v file, file name, we have selected the user's output. Here it displaying the message box as value, file name. We got the file path in the second bot. Like this, you can use the user's output and user's input like this.